How are you? I'm Ken Erman. I'm the product owner for the Mastercam design team. We spend a lot of time just listening to the users, spend a lot of time on the forum, seeing what people need, what they're asking for, and looking for ways to make those suggestions and turn them into opportunities to increase our capabilities. As a team, we understand that the end result of this is not just a pretty model that we can show on the screen and shade and flip around. The end result is something, a part that you're going to hold in your hand, that you can manufacture. And so that attitude really permeates our whole development team. I like to spend a lot of time just listening to users, and I like to hear what they're struggling with. I like to use feedback to the user because I really need to understand their process, really, the problem they're trying to solve. It's exciting. It's exciting to be able to do that. So it's an enjoyable part of the software to be working in. Well, you know, the mesh functionality was really introduced in the 2022 release. And we were pretty excited about it because we introduced a suite of tools that allow users to not only just import a mesh so you could cut it, but actually interact with it and fix it, right? Because most often, many times, your mesh is a scanned mess. And you need to take that scanned mess and turn it into something you can cut. One thing we realize is so many of the imported meshes have problems. And in the first release, you know, we were able to identify those problems and let the user go in and manually fix them. Well, we're frequently talking about 5 million triangles. So forcing the user to get in there to find those dozen or so triangles that are flipped or folded or slivers or just all kinds of things that can go wrong with them, we realize that that's not the ideal. So for the 2023 release, we were actually developed tools to be able to not only identify the problem areas, but to go ahead and fix them so the user can happily move on their way to doing the big work that needs to be done. We added the ability to fix those problem areas in a mesh. Well, oftentimes the solution is to remove those facets, which leaves a hole. Well, to identify where those spots are can be difficult. So by adding outlines over those areas when you're using the fill holes functionality, it's very obvious to the user where the holes are. And then the user can go in and select the ones that they want to fill, ignoring the others that they want to leave open. So again, saves you a lot of hunting and looking. It's very obvious. And so you select those highlighted edges. They show up in your list so you know what you have. And it makes the whole process go much quicker. One of the uses of a mesh is you may not be cutting the actual mesh. You want to use that mesh, though, as your stock model. And so you have your solid part or your surface model. You convert it to a mesh, but you want to offset it just a little bit, right, for your stock model. So by being able to add that functionality, we saved a lot of time that you don't have to go change the original physical model first. You can leave the physical model intact, the surfaces, the solids, whatever it is, create that mesh and then puff it up a little bit. So that's a pretty valuable thing to be able to do. When we think about lofting surfaces, you know, the users imported a file from somewhere, a mesh, a surface, but a surface model that may be problematic, right? Because we get some pretty nasty surface models in. They've been around maybe for decades. Making sure your cross sections are clean, making sure they're consistent entity counts, make sure that because the end result, right, we want the flow lines of those surfaces to be smooth. We don't want them wiggling all over the place because you don't want to see that in your tool paths. So yeah, the lofting, the dynamic syncing is what we introduced in Mastercam 2023 can really go a long way to making that process easier on the user They don't have to do as much preparation work to get those cross sections ready. A few years ago, we introduced the solid hole function, right? Where you can go to a table and grab a template and insert your quarter 20 holes, size the way you want them, wherever you want them on the model, and carrying that information, whether it's got chamfers on it, whether you've got counterbore holes or countersinks, and it's all controlled and it's all edited in a table in the function. But then really the next important step is to recognize hole information brought in to Mastercam via STEP or SolidWorks or Parasolid file or an SAT file, wherever it came from, to be able to analyze that model and create hole operations in an automated fashion. So now you take this brick with no intelligence in it and create solid hole operations. And with those operations, now you can edit those, right? So I can take a hole that is a quarter inch diameter and I can make it a 201 diameter, because then I know I'm going to drill and tap that. So I have a lot of control over prepping that model to manufacture. I've been in the industry 37 years, and I started out doing tech support for a CAD company. I've always been in close contact with customers, and so hearing what they want and solving their problem has always been a reward for me. And I think everybody on the team feels the same way. So as we roll out the software and people begin to use it and feedback from the field comes, and you know, sometimes the feedback is an indirect compliment in that, oh, hey, we've been using this function and boy, we could really use this or this added to it. Because what that tells us is they've used it, have adapted it into their workflow, but they also see more opportunities to take that further. I think one example that we're working on for the next release, Mastercam 2024, came in through an innocent kind of offhand comment on the forum asking for some functionality in a feature that's been around for a while. And, you know, we did some investigation. I interacted with the couple of users who chimed in that conversation, that thread, and we were able to kind of turn around and produce something for them. Of course, you're not going to see it until next year, but I think it's exactly what they want. This is Mastercam 2023.